Let me tell you something. The practice of tithing has not been a church's invention. As well as the Sabbath, it has been established by God Himself, and it is practiced by all those who recognize Him as the Creator and Provider, and who accept the Bible as His Word. It was by Jesus Christ Himself, who gave His life for the life of the world, that this plan was devised. Abraham paid tithe long before the establishment of the Jewish nation, because instead of being a Jewish institution, tithe was planned to be a blessing to the whole of humanity. When alone, far from home, and with no material support, Jacob also promised to God, "Of all that you give me, I will surely give a tenth to you." As the Israelites were about to be established as a nation, the law of tithing was reaffirmed. "And all tithe of the land is the Lord's. It is holy unto the Lord. And concerning tithe of the herd or the flock, of whatever passes under the rod, the tenth one shall be holy unto the Lord." But how can I know if tithe should really be 10% of all the income or increase? Can I return a different percentage as tithe? Should I return it from my salary only? What about the other incomes? Good questions. The very word tithe is a translation from the Hebrew word maaser, which means a tenth or 10%, which is the same. So, as any percentage different from that cannot be called tithe, it is very important for the believer to regularly verify all the income or increase from any source, recognize it as coming from God, and calculate the exact amount that represents one-tenth of the blessing. Let us follow Solomon's invitation. Honor the Lord with your possessions and with the first fruits of all your increase, so your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine.